Hey y'all, hi, Mandy here, and welcome to my living room. I'm going to be doing a living room tour and a dining room tour at some point on my main channel. This video, I don't know if this is going to end up on my main channel or my secondary channel, but I don't know. I just wanted to talk. So, I guess, this beauty is from HomeGoods. This pillow is from HomeGoods. Target, HomeGoods. And I think that's the only stuff you guys can see that I can give you information on. So, I feel like I need to scooch up something. Today I wanted to talk to you guys about books because I just finished this one the other night. That's why I was so sleepy the other day. When I was wearing like the navy floral top, I was really tired, but oh my god. Because I stayed up the night before and finished this because I was just so close to being done. And then I finished this book like eons ago and never talked about it, and I really wanted to because I really enjoyed it. But let's talk about this one first since I did just finish this most recently. It's The Power. Maybe I'm tired today. I'm thinking of a different book that I had read, The Power of the Female Brain or something. The Emotional Intelligence Quick Book, Everything You Need to Know to Put Your EQ to Work by Travis Bradley, no, it's a Sam Adult sticker, Bradbury and Jean Greaves. So there it is. And as you can see from the sticker, it's one of those books that you get on that section, that display in Barnes & Noble's where they're all marked down, but it's like, were they kind of always that price marked down? Is this a trick? Because everything that's there always looks like it's always been there. But I digress. That's where I got this book. And I actually, on LinkedIn, somehow ended up following maybe one or both of these guys, or maybe like just their company. And so, hold that thought. The battery is dying. I will be right back. So, as I was saying before I ran upstairs to get a fresh battery, I somehow ended up on like a LinkedIn email list or something for one of these people. And so I get like emails about emotional intelligence stuff by work email, and it's always work related or like office setting related. So, the Emotional Intelligence book is always something that I thought I would pick up at some point, but then when I saw it at discount, and actually we had stopped at a Barnes & Noble in Salisbury, Maryland, because we were on our way to Ocean City, and I realized I hadn't brought my book that I wanted to read, so I needed a book to read, because, you know, going to the beach, lounging by the pool, you need to read. So it's actually really simply written. It's written to really be accessible language-wise to a lot of people. I found the writing really simplistic, but I guess with something like this where it's almost a guide, you want to keep it simplistic so that a lot of people are reading and actually comprehending what is being said. But most of it I just wasn't a fan of. A lot of the stuff, and maybe it's just because I've been through a lot of things in my life that kind of forced me to be a little more in touch with my emotions. Some of this just felt like common sense to me. I don't know. I enjoyed the section about, what is it called? I'm gonna find it. No, where is it? I don't remember which section it was. There's a section in here where it kind of talked about emotional intelligence with like relation to relationships. So I kind of liked that bit because obviously I'm newly engaged and I can be a little bit of like a bulldozer. I know this about myself. Like, not in everyday situations, but when, with a partner, I know I can be the one that's like dominating, making decisions. And so for me in Austin, it ends up working because
he gets very caught up in his thoughts and wants to research everything and know all the information, and sometimes things don't need to have that much thought involved in them. So I'm really good at just making the decision and going with it. But I need to be better about listening when he does have a decision made or an idea, because I'm not used to it, I guess. So I need to be better about making sure I take in what he's saying and his feedback and accept some of it. And I'm getting better at it. It's a slow process, but yeah. So overall, I feel like if you have no idea what emotional intelligence is, it might be a nice quick read to kind of verse yourself on it, but overall, I feel like this is totally worth skipping, and you can just go for a more in-depth, interesting, maybe research-based emotional intelligence book, and not one that's called Quick Book. So I wouldn't recommend that one. I'm just not a fan. And then on to the second book. This is Most Talkative by Andy Cohen. I feel like I keep hitting books. I need to stop doing that because I'm sure it's annoying people who are watching this. So this is Most Talkative by Andy Cohen. Obviously, Andy Cohen's on Bravo. He's a producer. He is the host of Watch What Happens Live. I love Andy Cohen. I just think he's so funny. And this book basically kind of chronicles his career. Well, he talks a little bit about his childhood and then college and studying abroad and then the early years of his career. And that's really where, I mean, all, there are funny stories in all of them, but the early years of his career into like Bravo and early Housewives, that's where I find it most interesting because I can actually put context to it. Some of this, like, I wasn't necessarily alive for. So, like, some of the crazy pictures with his wild hair, like, I'm not sure I was alive for all of that, but it was just really funny. I find him to be really funny. It's light, it's easy, it's super accessible, the writing's not complicated, but in the same vein, it's not too easy to where if you are someone who is, like, oh my god, every sentence is the same. It's not gonna bother you. It's not like that. So, I definitely recommend this. If you are a Bravo fan, if you are a Housewives fan, if you are an Andy fan, definitely look into this because it is hilarious. And yeah, that's basically it. I'm not the greatest at reviewing books. I'm sure in time I may get better, but I'm just not the greatest at reviewing books. That's just what it is. But I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Just a little bit of chit-chat, something different. I'm sorry if I keep, like, changing lighting. The TV is on, but it's on mute. And so, like, as the lighting changes on TV, I'm probably changing lighting too. But anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. And if you did, you can give it a thumbs up. If you have any comments or questions, you can leave them down below. If you'd like to stick around for a while, you can hit that subscribe button. And if you'd like to be notified every time I post a video, you can hit the little bell button next to the subscribe button. And otherwise, I will talk to you all later. Bye!